Sri Lanka is so overrated. It looks just like India. ये सिर्फ वो लोग बोलते हैं who end up in the overly touristic places. I did solo travel in the country last month and bhai, the real beauty of Sri Lanka lies in its offbeat locations and adventure travel. So here's the hidden itinerary that is nowhere else on the internet. Let's get started. Day 1. Land in the capital of Sri Lanka, Colombo. You can take a tuk-tuk from the airport to your hotel. This is the most common and cheap mode of transport here. Use the apps Uber and Pickme to book one. Tomorrow early morning, we are taking a train to the hippie town of Ella. Day 2. Good morning, I'm in the train station. I'm about to take the most beautiful train ride in Asia. So this is a special train called Ella Odyssey, which actually goes from Colombo to Ella. And there are a lot of stopping points in the middle, which is like Nuwara area and Horton and stuff. And you can see waterfalls and tea estates, and you see extremely beautiful views. Yeah? It doesn't run all the time, like it's probably Thursday and Saturday, but you should check the timetable before getting it. Please book a ticket on the second or third class because the first class is pretty closed, so you won't be getting an authentic experience, like you won't be able to feel the outdoors. I booked the tickets through the website 12O Asia and it cost me 1200 INR or close to $15. You get like an online ticket and then you have to come to the railway station here and get the physical ticket.
Remember that this train ride is 10 hours and can be quite long. So you can also break it down into 2 days. First day, go from Colombo to Kandy and second day from Kandy to Ella. Though Kandy is a small hill station and there's nothing much to see here. Day 3.
Okay, so we have just started the hike to Ella's Rock and I've come with my hostel friends Adrian and Annie.
Hello!
There are no signboards here to the Ella's Rock, but we are just using maps.me.
So, which app are you using, Adrian?
I'm using Maps.me.
You can't follow Google Maps.
Okay, so we were following the path, but there's a lot of jungle on the way. We found Roshan, who is a local. It's a little bit moderate to go up here. So yeah, just have some food before coming. It was raining the whole day yesterday. We started really early today, like 6 in the morning. So there are a lot of leeches on the way.
It's going inside.
Put that all before coming here and wear like full pants and socks to cover your legs at least. This is the top of the Ella's Rock. You need to pay an extra 900 rupees or 200 INR to go there. But the view is basically the same, so you can see from here. But right now it's very clouded. It's clouds all over, so we can't really see anything. But the views on the way were really beautiful, so it's totally worth it. So the top was very clouded, but this is like almost the top, but the view is really good. Like I think this is very close to what we would see from the top. That over there is the little Adam's Peak, so you can also see it while climbing the Ella Rock.
If you don't like a proper hike like this, you can also go to that little Adam's Peak. It's a short climb with a beautiful view.
Day 4. Start exploring the exotic beaches of Sri Lanka from the Hirikitiya beach. The waters are so beautiful here. You can also visit Turtle Point, Tangol and Dikwela beaches nearby. Day 5. Veligama is the best beach to do surfing for beginners. There are so many surf schools here and you must try at least one class with a teacher for around 1200 INR. So I rented my own surfboard for 150 INR per hour and surfed daily. This is literally why Sri Lanka is so popular. Surfing! Veligama is also just 10 to 15 minutes away from popular places like Mirisa and Ahangama. You can take a day trip to these places and stay at a budgeted place in Veligama. Even party scenes are too lit nearby. Doctor's House has a cool DJ every Wednesday and Saturday. Party 4 baje tak chalti hai is area mein, boss. For underground parties, check Under the Radar on Instagram. Day 6.
Look at the color of water. It is so beautiful, so blue and green and all the shades. Oh my god, this is Unuvatuna Beach. Initially I skipped it, but after coming here I'm like, why did I do that? A lot of Indians actually don't come here and it's literally the best beach that I've seen in Sri Lanka. I just came back from a scuba dive.
So we're diving in Unuvatuna and the water has been very clear for the last few days and we're super excited because we can actually get to see some marine life.
Oh my god, we saw so many fishes and corals, like purple, shining, and oh my god, it was just surreal. And I actually went with the seahorse diving school and they are so good, they're so professional. Took me to the really good reefs.
Make sure you leave a gap of 24 hours after scuba to take your flight. You can also do a day trip to the Dutch town of Gaul from here.
Honestly, the rest of the Sri Lanka doesn't look even close to like this. The Portuguese and then the Dutch and the British came to Sri Lanka from the 1500s. It was properly colonized. I have come to see the Gaul fort and it's the best surviving European architecture in Asia right now. You can see the lighthouse and also the museum. There's no entry fees. Come see the Doctor Street and there's a lot of shopping here and a lot of cafes. Really nice, really beautiful streets. It actually reminds me of Goa, but Goa is Portuguese architecture, this is Dutch architecture.
Day 7. Take a bus to Colombo and fly back to India. So here is the final itinerary and everything you learned just now. If you like the video, don't forget to subscribe and watch the next video down here.